How to answer the most annoying interview question ever. Tell me about yourself.
Hi, thanks for coming in today. So, tell me a little bit about yourself. I'm from Maryland, and my dad always wanted me to go to business school, even though I really wanted to go to film school, which was annoying. So I ended up going to University of Maryland because he said he'd pay for it if I went there. So I went there, and I was in a sorority, and that was really fun. And then I ended up here. So I hate my boss, so looking for a change. Thanks for coming in today. So tell me a little bit about yourself. Yeah, well, I'm from Maryland. I went to the University of Maryland, and I graduated in 2017 with a major in business and a minor in media and communications. And then after college, I moved to New York City, where I now work as an acquisitions manager at HBO, which I totally love. But now I'm looking to pivot to more of a boutique agency where I can have a smaller team and more creative freedom.
How to answer the most irritating interview question ever. Why should we hire you?
Thanks for coming in today. So why should we hire you?
I don't know. I mean, you posted the ad saying you need someone and I'm here.
You should hire me for my skills, experience, and personality. I will work harder than anyone else you're considering. Thanks for coming in today. So, why should we hire you? That's a great question. As you can see on my resume, I have all the hard skills that you're looking for in a candidate. I have 10 years of editing experience, I know how to produce, and I have a degree in marketing. But I also have the soft skills you need for this job. I'm a team player, I'm a collaborator, I'm a clear communicator, and I have a sense of humor. But I've been following this company for a while now, and I know that you're looking for somebody who can really take ownership of this role. I have ideas that I think will help this company achieve its short-term and long-term goals, and I would love the opportunity to share them with the team.
How to answer. What is your greatest strength in a job interview?
What would you say is your greatest strength?
I don't know. Nothing comes to mind.
Well, I'm really good at making money. I have a lot of money, and I'll make this company a lot of money.
I'm really, really good at what I do. When you hire me today, you won't regret it.
What would you say is your greatest strength?
I think one of my greatest strengths is my ability to focus. I'm really grateful that I've always had a really good ability to focus, and it contributes to my ability to consistently make deadlines. Something I've been told in the past is that I have a really good attitude, and I inspire those around me to be more creative. So I guess that's one of my strengths. I've had previous managers tell me that I'm really dependable. They can always count on me to get the job done right and on time, and it just means a lot to me when they tell me that.
How to answer another annoying interview question. What is your greatest weakness?
Hi, thanks for coming in today. So, what are some of your greatest weaknesses?
I work too hard, I care too much, and sometimes I can be too invested in my job.
Hi, thanks for coming in today. So, what are some of your greatest weaknesses?
Oh gosh, where do I begin? Just kidding. But really, something that I'm working on right now is just my general confidence. I tend to have a lot of anxiety when it comes to public speaking or giving presentations, and honestly, even right now in this interview, I'm feeling a little bit of anxiety. So something that I've done in the past year is that I joined a public speaking group where we give speeches in front of each other, and that's been really helping me with my confidence and with my presentation skills.
I am so impressed with the potential you see in me.
How to answer. What is your greatest weakness? Part 2.
So, what is your greatest weakness? What kind of question is that? But actually, there is a foolproof formula for answering this question. And that is picking a weakness that is true, but has nothing really to do with your job performance. For example, if you're going into accounting, you wouldn't want to say you're bad at math. If you're going into sales, you wouldn't want to say you're not a people person. If you're going into filmmaking, you would not say collaboration is a weakness. If you're trying to go into firefighting, you would not say that you don't perform well under pressure. You want to say something that doesn't really matter. I can be a little serious and intense in the workplace, but I'm working on dialing it back and incorporating my sense of humor. I struggle a little bit with impatience. I like things to happen quickly. But I'm aware of this weakness and I'm actively working to practice patience. One of my weaknesses is computer skills. I don't know why, but it just doesn't come naturally to me. But I'm taking an online course right now and it's really helping.
How to answer. What is your greatest strength? Without sounding cocky.
There's a trick to answering this question that will help you sound more humble when you're essentially bragging about yourself. And it's really simple. Just credit the compliment to somebody else. Here's an example. My manager at my last job always complimented me on how organized I was. So I suppose that's one of my strengths. A previous mentor once told me that I'm a good person to have around in a sticky situation. And to me, that's a huge compliment. When I was an intern at CNN, my boss would always tell me that he really appreciated how no task was too big or too little for me. He said I was always ready to tackle anything that came my way, and that meant a lot to me. Try these out, let me know if they work for you, and follow for more.
How to answer the absolute worst interview question. Why do you want to work here?
Hi, thanks for coming in today. So, why do you want to work here? That's a good question. You see, I'm really passionate about having money so that I don't die. Wait. Hold your horses there. I know this question sucks, but here's a trick that will make answering this question so much easier. If you're interviewing for Chick-fil-A and they ask you why you want to work there, don't think, why do I want to work at Chick-fil-A? Instead, think, why do I want to work for Chick-fil-A over KFC or babysitting? Why do you want to work for Chick-fil-A over other options? Which will help you narrow down actual reasons why you want to work there. Maybe you like the food. Maybe you already have the menu memorized. Maybe you had a friend that worked there. Maybe you really like how the employees are always so nice. Let me know if the tip helps and follow for more.
How to answer. Why do you want to go to this college university?
Hi, thanks for coming in today. So why do you want to go to this college?
I don't really know. It was just on the Common app and I just applied. It was a pretty easy application.
Hi, thanks for coming in today. So why do you want to go to this college? I've always wanted to go to NYU ever since I was young. It's always been a dream ever since I found out that many of the filmmakers that I love graduated from NYU. I know some of NYU's values revolve around encouraging students to be collaborative and take risks. You seek students who are curious about others and the world around them. NYU also values diversity and inclusion, which are very important to me as an aspiring female filmmaker. I'm also only looking at universities in New York City because I want to start developing my network here. I'm ambitious, I want to tell thought-provoking stories, and I know NYU is an environment where I can thrive.
How to answer the annoying job interview question. Tell me about a time you failed.
So, tell me about a time that you failed.
I've never failed, I'm perfect. I miscalculated some numbers and lost my company thousands of dollars. Got fired for it too. I failed my driver's license test like 4 times.
So, tell me about a time that you failed. As a video editor, failure to me is any time I can't meet or exceed a client's expectations. At a previous job, I had to edit a series of commercials. I had a ton on my plate and it was a tight deadline. I was overwhelmed and failed to communicate this to my manager, which caused the project to be late and the client was very upset. Of course, now I know how to gauge what I can handle and what I can commit to completing. And now I make it a priority to communicate my capacity to my managers.
How to answer? Tell me about your previous job experience. When you have no previous job experience.
Hi, thanks for coming in today. So can you tell me about your previous job experience?
So I've actually never had a real job before. I mean, I've like babysat and stuff, but I've never had like a real job. But I was hoping that this would just be like a good learning experience for me, you know?
Hi, thanks for coming in today. So can you tell me a little bit about your previous job experience?
Absolutely. So I've actually been focusing on my studies to maintain my GPA to keep my scholarship since I put myself through school and I'm actually the first person in my family to graduate from college. I've also been focusing on extracurricular activities like film club and refining my post-production skills in softwares like Adobe, Premiere, and After Effects. And now I'm excited to finally get out into the professional world and put my skills to good use. I'm creative, I'm a self-starter, and I love collaboration.
How to answer? Tell me about a time when you had to deal with a difficult customer.
Can you tell me about a time where you had to deal with a difficult customer?
Oh my god, this one time, this bitch. It's like, well, she started it and then I just left.
Can you tell me about a time when you had to deal with a difficult customer?
Absolutely. So one memory that comes to mind is when I was working the cashier at lunchtime and a woman came in and she was insisting on using a coupon that was expired. And so I told the lady that I could not ring it up because it was expired and I showed her the expiration date. She started to get very angry and started to yell and demand to speak to my manager, who I knew was busy at the time. So I had a long line of customers, so I took a deep breath and I remembered that my manager told me that I could offer a free dessert in this scenario. So I did offer her that free dessert, she seemed pretty satisfied, and I was able to move on to the next customer in line.
How to absolutely crush an internship interview.
Number one, research the company. Read their entire website, follow them on all social medias, and read about their CEO / founder. They'll be really impressed if you know about their CEO or founder. Number two, look good. If it's on Zoom, make sure that your lighting is on point, make sure your Wi-Fi is strong, and your background isn't distracting. If it's an in-person interview, make sure your breath is fresh and skip the cologne or perfume. Number three, be the most enthusiastic version of yourself. Companies like interns because they add a sense of youth to the office. And they do tasks that nobody else wants to do. But mainly, they just want to know that you're going to be a self-starter and a go-getter. So have a great attitude. Number four, prepare. Prepare your answers for their questions and prepare your questions for them at the end. And finally, number five, send a follow-up email. A few hours after your interview is done or the next day, send an email.
tell them thank you. Remind them of who you are. This can make all the world of difference. Good luck.
How to answer the tricky interview question. Why did you leave your last job?
So, why did you leave your last job? Oh my God, my boss was a total bitch. I was fired because they claimed I stole something, but they didn't have any proof. Ugh, don't even get me started. I hated it there. It was so toxic. I wasn't getting paid enough, so I was like, see ya. So, why did you leave your last job? I was actually let go from my last position. My previous role wasn't a great fit for me, and I made some mistakes, but I learned from them. Although I really liked the company, I felt like I wasn't being challenged enough in my last role. The company and I were moving at different speeds, and I'm looking to take on more responsibility in a new role. Unfortunately, I was laid off due to the company struggling financially. It was hard for me because I really loved my job and coworkers. But ultimately, it was a good thing because it led me to be able to pursue this job. I actually left my previous role due to personal reasons. There was a dramatic shift in my personal life, and I had to take off some time. But now that everything is resolved, I couldn't be more excited to get back to work.
How to answer what makes you unique in a college internship interview?
So, what makes you unique? I can lick my elbow. Wanna see? My sister is actually my mom. Well, that's kind of rude. I memorized the entire B-movie script. So, what makes you unique? One unique fact about me is that growing up, my family actually owned and operated a funeral home, which led me to develop a deep sense of emotional intelligence at a young age, which is the reason why I want to go into communications. One fun fact about me is that I actually grew up on an apple orchard in rural Pennsylvania, so I'd love to be really involved with the on-campus garden. I am a really determined person. When I was younger, my brother beat me in a game of chess, and it made me so mad that I learned the entire game of chess inside and out, and I can proudly say I am undefeated in the game of chess now.
How to answer, why do you want this job? In an interview.
Why do you want this job? I don't know, I just really need a job. I heard you guys pay really well and I'm trying to get a Tesla. I think this job would be a really good stepping stone for my career. So why do you want this job? I've had my eye on this company ever since freshman year when I saw you did that campaign with Serena Williams. It seems every campaign this agency puts out is a huge success, and every time I see one, I just kick myself because I wish I had worked on it. I noticed for this role, you're seeking somebody who is truly passionate about the future of influencer marketing. I have the passion, I know the softwares, I know the metrics. I've worked with large brands like Target and Pantene. But I'm also flexible and I'm still learning every day and keeping up to date with the latest trends. With new platforms like TikTok and Clubhouse, I'm personally so excited about the future of influencer marketing. Personally, I feel like this company's approach to marketing directly aligns with mine. I would love to contribute to this agency's success.
Unique questions to ask at the end of a job interview.
So, do you have any questions for us? Yes, I do actually, but I want to be mindful of your time. How much time do we have left for this interview? How has COVID affected business? I saw this recent campaign/merger in the news. Was that successful for you? I know this company recently posted about this initiative on your social media. Could you tell me a little bit more about that? I saw company X, who I assume is one of your competitors, recently did this. Will this company be following suit? How is this company currently accommodating employees during the pandemic? If you had to pick one, what would you say is the single most important soft skill for this role? Are the compensation and benefits for this role on par with the industry average? I read that your CEO's motto is this. Could you tell me a little bit more about that? What do you think will be the most challenging part of this role in the next year? I saw the company is pet friendly. Do people bring their dogs in? Is there anything I can do to strengthen my application? When can I expect to hear back about the position?
How to ask for a raise with a chill or busy boss.
Hey boss, can I have a raise? Hey, I heard everybody's getting raises, what the heck? If you don't start paying me more, I'm gonna quit. Just kidding, but really. Hey boss, would you have any time today or tomorrow to sit down for a second? 4:30? Cool. Hey, is now still a good time? Cool. So I'd love to discuss the possibility of me getting a raise. I am prepared to make my case, but I know that you're busy, so I just wanted to cut straight to the point. Thanks, I appreciate that. I mean, you've done a lot of great work this year. What number are you thinking? Thank you. Well, according to my research, a 10% raise would stay consistent with the market average for somebody with my skill set. Okay, well, I'll talk to HR and I'll get back to you on Monday. But you've been doing some great work for us, so I'm sure we can figure something out. Thank you so much. Have a good weekend.
2. Yeah. Dress for a job interview.
Yeah. Whoa. I'm so pretty and he like that. When he beat it up, he deep inside that kitty cat. Kitty cat, loose and focus, just like Fetty Wap. Now where he at? Cause I'm trying to make a movie set. I know he don't like it when I talk back. Run my mouth like Forrest Gump, but I like it when he talk back. Make my pussy thigh when he show me up. Zip it up, then beat it up. Never yelling while we pipe it up. I saw a fucking white outside and I'm scared.
How to stop using so many filler words?
You know what I mean? Like, so, you know? As a chronic word filler myself, I know how hard it can be to stop. It comes from a desire to fill silence because we subconsciously think that silence makes the other person feel uncomfortable, but it doesn't. So here's a trick to help you stop using fillers so much. Number one, record yourself giving an answer to an interview question. You need to understand what fillers you use and where you put them. Number two, slow down. This is hard for me to communicate on TikTok because I only have 60 seconds, but slow down. Number three, take 1 to 3 seconds before answering. Literally count 1, 2. Why do you think you'd be a good fit for this role? Well, there are a lot of reasons. There are a couple reasons why. Now, I think some ums are okay. We're all human. But if you feel like this is an issue, I hope these tips can be helpful for you.
How to write a cover letter.
This was a super popular request, so I'm going to walk you through my favorite cover letter template. First, start with your salutation. If you know their name, hi Chris, hello is safe, or to whom it may concern if it's more formal. Then introduce yourself. I'm excited to submit my application for this position at this company. Then, an acknowledgement. I know that you probably get a ton of applications and cover letters, so I'll keep this brief. Then, make your case. As a humble brag memorable detail, I truly believe I'd be a great fit for this position. My background in this, I know I can achieve this. What truly excites me about this role is this opportunity or this challenge. Then move into the skills. Take the original job posting and use as many of those words in this part of the cover letter as you can. For this specific role, I have all the hard skills you're looking for. This, this, and this. But I also have all the soft skills. This, this, and this. But I truly pride myself in being this and this. Then the final acknowledgement. Thank you for your time. I look forward to talking to you more. You can reach me anytime at this, and then close out.
Oh no, I got 2 job offers at the same time. One from mug company and one from glass company. Whatever shall I do?
Okay, I know the props are stupid, just like go along with it.
I really want to work with mug company. They're everything I love, and I really just applied to glass as a backup. The first thing that I'm gonna do is email both companies to make sure I have a written offer to make sure that everything is confirmed. Okay, they both gave me a written offer. I'm gonna send an email to Mug to negotiate with them, and then have Glass as my fallback. Hi Mug Company, thank you so much for your offer. I'm so honored and flattered and excited to join the team. Are you able to do $5,000 more? Dear Glass Company, thank you so much for your generous offer. I will review and get back to you ASAP. Mug Company got back to me and said yes to my $5,000 ask. This is ideal. Now I'm working with my first choice company and I was able to negotiate a higher salary. But what do I do with Glass Company? I'm gonna send them a really nice email. Dear Glass Company, thank you so much for your time and your generous offer. I've decided to take another offer, but I sincerely hope that we cross paths in the future. Now this leaves an opportunity for Glass to give me a sweeter offer. But let's say they don't. Instead they just say, it was nice to meet me and they wish me luck. Okay, Glass is out of the picture. Now everyone is happy and we can agree to Mug with full confidence. Follow for more.